Hello viewers, a warm welcome to the video lecture on mercerization process. At the end of the video, you will be able to state the purpose of mercerization process, recap the methods of mercerization, summarize the physical action on substrate, explain the mechanism involved in mercerization process, describe the procedure involved in ammonia treatment. Finally, you will be able to test the barium activity of mercerized sample. Now let us see the introduction and purpose of mercerization. In 1844, John Mercer observed the effect of physical changes takes place on cotton fabric while filtering caustic soda solution using cotton fabric as a filter. In 1850, he filed a patent for treatment of cotton with concentrated sodium hydroxy solution with improvement in strength and dyeability. In 1890, Horace Lowy found if shrinkage is controlled, the fabric becomes lusher. So tension mercerization was observed by Lowy and slack mercerization was observed by John Mercer. So mercerization is carried out for the following purpose. It improves lusher of the material. It looks like silk fabric during the tension mercerization. It improves tensile strength and dimension stability of cotton fabric. Increases uniformity of dyeing and improves color yield, thereby saving the dye step during the process. Improves elasticity or stretch of the material during the slack mercerization process. Now we will be discussing about the types of mercerization. Basically, there are two types of mercerization. One is tension mercerization, the second one is slack mercerization. The tension mercerization, the purpose of mercerization is to increase the lustre of cotton fiber. The fiber untwists and swells, lumen becomes rounder in cross section and it gains lustre. Dye affinity and chemical reactivity increases, fabric becomes stronger and smoother. In case of slack mercerization, the lustre is not so as tension mercerization. Elongation and recovery property improves and thus have been used to produce comfort stretch garments and fabric bandages which need to conform to the body shapes. Now I am going to discuss about the mechanism involved in mercerization process. Mercerization is a process of treating the cotton fabric with concentrated caustic soda solution at very cold temperature. Keeping in contact with the cold solution for a given period of time with or without tension and subsequently rinsing it. The mechanism in tension mercerization. So mercerization causes swelling in fiber. Swelling causes cross section to become rounder and loss of convolutions takes place and de-twisting also takes place during the mercerization process. Finally, you are getting a more lustre surface. Please look at the figure. This is a regular cotton fibers cross section. After mercerization, it becomes either circular in cross section or elliptical in cross section. This opening of fiber structure takes place during the mercerization process. Increase in amorphous content due to decrystallization. Please look at the figure. The amorphous content has been increased after the mercerization process. Mercerization is accompanied by swelling. It is closely related to internal modification of fiber. So, effect is absorbed at 18 to 24% caustic soda solution. Then, high number of hydroxyl groups available as compared to unmercerized cotton. Then, high moisture content and dye uptake and reactivity is also absorbed in mercerized cotton fabric. Now, I would like to discuss about the swelling mechanism in mercerization process. On mercerization, the fiber swells gradually and the false twist and convolutions gradually disappears. The cross section becomes almost circular and the fiber acquires the shape of a regular uniform cylindrical. This process of gradual change in fiber cross section is dissipated in the figure below. Please look at the figure. There is a gradual changes in cross section of cotton fiber from bean shape to circular in cross section. In the figure, the stage 1 to 5 shows swelling of cross section of fiber. It is easy to see the conversion of bean shaped into cylindrical in cross section, almost a round shape or a cylindrical cross section, and a gradual disappearance of the lumen may take place during the mercerization process. Please look at the figure. The lumen will gradually disappear as soon as the fiber swelling takes place. The stage 6 and 7 are associated with the removal of sodium hydroxide from fiber on washing and drying. It is important to note that on loss of sodium hydroxide during washing and subsequent drying, the fiber shrinks in cross-sectional area but maintains its round shape. Please look at the figure. Even though the absence of sodium hydroxide, the fiber maintains its round shape in cross-section. Overall, there is a little gain in fiber volume due to mercerization, and hence the density of fiber remains unaffected. Kindly look at the slide. There is an increase in tensile strength during the mercerization process. How it will take place? See, removal of convolutions results in removal of weak places present in the material. So, fibers have more uniform in structure, circular and smooth cross-section after the mercerization process. The fibrils are arranged parallel to the fiber axis. So, the fiber alignment along the fiber axis is better in tension mercerization as compared to the slack mercerization. So, this is how the increase in tensile strength has been obtained during the mercerization process. Please look at the slide, the effect of sodium hydroxide concentration. 16 to 18 degree twaddle, it gives incomplete untwisting, whereas 26 degree twaddle, rapid untwisting takes place in cotton fiber. If 35 degree twaddle, untwisting followed by swelling takes place. Whereas if you maintain 40 degree twaddle and above, untwisting and swelling together takes place in the cotton fiber. Now look at the slide. It shows the physical changes takes place during the mercerization process. Effect of caustic soda solution on cotton fiber. Fiber swelling takes place, breaking of old bonds, opening of fiber structure, swelling not only in the amorphous region but in the intracrystalline region. On removal of caustic soda by washing, new bonds are formed, extension of hydrogen bonds in intracrystalline region are not to the same extent compared to the unmercerized cotton. Increase in amorphous content, increase in number of hydroxyl groups. So both these factors are responsible for high moisture content, increased dye uptake and increased reactivity. So amorphous content is more in slack mercerization compared to tension mercerization. See, so far we have discussed about the mercerization process using caustic soda solution. Now we will discuss about the ammonia mercerization process. What do you mean by ammonia mercerization process? Ammonia mercerization is a treatment of cotton fiber with ammonia, which produces a similar effect to that obtained with caustic soda solution. So among various amines, the liquid ammonia appears to be unique in its swelling action on cotton and its effect also on crystal structure. Liquid ammonia treatment was first developed by Coates in the year 1960. Now let us see the cross-sectional changes takes place during the ammonia mercerization process. See, please look at the figure. The stage 1 shows the cross-section before the mercerization process. The stage 2 to 5, the swelling takes place during the ammonia mercerization process. Stage 2, 3, 4, 5. If you look at this figure, the same effect we have observed in the sodium hydroxide. Here also we have observed the same effect in case of ammonia treatment. The stage 6, rinsing process after swelling. Please see the figure. This shows the stage 6 rinsing process, that is the after the removal of ammonia present in the fabric. The stage 7 after the treatment. Please look at the figure. Even after the removal of ammonia, the cross-sectional remains same, that is round shape in cross-section. So we are getting the similar effect which was observed in caustic soda treatment. Now we will discuss about the disadvantages of ammonia treatment, why this ammonia treatment is not so popular in textile industry. So the main reasons are, in order to keep the liquid ammonia in liquid form, it must be stored below 33 degrees Celsius. So it is very difficult to maintain below 33 degrees Celsius during the storage period. It forms explosive moisture with air. Similarly, when leakage takes place during the mercerization process, it is highly affected to the workers. So these are all the main three reasons why this ammonia treatment is not so popular in textile industry in order to perform the mercerization of cotton material. The slide shows the determination of degree of mercerization. See, mercerized and unmercerized cotton samples are treated with 30 ml of barium hydroxide for about 2 hours in a conical flask at room temperature. See, preferential absorption of barium hydroxide by cotton samples reduces the strength of barium hydroxide solution. The amount of barium hydroxide solution absorbed can be determined by taking 10 ml of barium hydroxide solution from each of the conical flask and titrating with hydrochloric acid, phenethylene being used as an indicator during the titration process. Fresh barium hydroxide solution is also titrated to assess the actual barium hydroxide in solution. So barium activity number is assessed by the below formula. Barium activity number equal to B minus M divided by B minus C into 100, where B is the volume of hydrochloric acid required for blank titration, where M is the volume of hydrochloric acid required with mercerized cotton, where C is the volume of hydrochloric acid required for unmercerized cotton. See, for complete mercerized cotton, the value of barium activity number is around 155. For semi-mercerized cotton, the barium activity number between 115 to 130. This is the summary of the video lecture on mercerization process. See, we have discussed the purpose of mercerization process, then methods of mercerization, physical and chemical changes takes place during the mercerization process. We have also discussed the mechanism involved in the mercerization process, procedure involved in ammonia treatment. Finally, we have discussed about the testing of mercerized sample. Thank you. Thank you for watching the lecture. Please subscribe this lecture.